Good morning for the garage. Brother Brian's here. Hey, check this old turntable. This guy at work brought me this week. It's an old Girard SL55 turntable, and it has the instructions. It's got all the paperwork. It's from the original owner. You know, back in the 60s, that's when this thing was made. Plastic was actually a thing. It was a thing, believe it or not, back in the 60s. The turntable itself was made out of aluminum. It has the Shure M3D cartridge, which is one fantastic cartridge. If you've never heard of Shure M3D cartridge, and you're an old soul like me, you are missing out because they sound phenomenal. I've also got the Shure M70 cartridge. The M70 was a machine-made cartridge, but it was made off of the same specifications as the Shure M3D. But the M-Shure 3D was handmade cartridge. And that's what's on this, is the Shure M3D. It's a fantastic cartridge. I don't care what people, you know, until you hear one, I'm telling you, you don't know what you're missing, because they are pleasant, very pleasant, warm, well-balanced. I really enjoy listening to the Shure M3D. And they're kind of hard to find. You can actually find them. I'll tell you what, you would be surprised if you go to the Goodwills and stuff and look at the old record players. You might actually accidentally find a nice, you know, if you get on eBay and try to buy them, they're anywhere from $200 to $400 to $500. But you could find them. I mean, you'd be surprised, because they're ugly, they're black, they don't look like much, but it ain't about what they look like. It's about what they sound like. You know what I'm saying? So, but this is a Girard turntable. This company's been around since the early 1700s. They were a jewelry maker. They made jewelry for the royal family. And my condolences go out to all those over in England that lost their beautiful and gracious queen. She was a beautiful person. I always, you know, thought, you know what? What an example for humanity. So my condolences to you. But Girard, they started out making jewelry. They were jewelry people in the 1700s. And then the wars broke out in the 1900s. And they started making the Girard Engineering Company. And they started making parts for the war, motors and such. And then they began to make turntables. And they make a beautiful turntable. This is, like I said, it doesn't look like much. This is plastic. This is the thing back in the 60s. But this is aluminum. This isn't like a super high-end turntable, but it's still a beautiful turntable, and it works perfectly. So yeah, it's just, guy at work brought this in to me. He cleans vents out, you know, home ventilation, cleans the vents out, and the guy had this, and he sold it to him for $10, and then he brought it to work, and he sold it to me for $25. I love the green dust cover. It does have a couple little scratches on it, but it's from the 60s, you know. This thing's really old. It's got a two-piece dust cover. I really enjoy it. Everything works on it. It's got the, check this out. It's got a little compartment here where you got your stacker, and then you can put your pen there. And then you got another compartment in the back here where you put your 45 adapter. You can put a 45 adapter, which I've got one here that I'm working on. I'm going to try to see if I can make that 45 adapter work so I can stack some 45s and play them. I think that'd be really fun. It runs on rails here. It's got a rail here. Now, this isn't everybody's cup of tea, I understand, but I love vintage stuff, man. And then over here, I got my Kenwood with the beautiful tubes glowing. It's a Kenwood 1100 stereo receiver. Got three transformers. It's got the 7591A tubes. Those are new old stock, fairly new tubes. They're still kind of in the burn-in process. I bought this thing. It was in pieces. That's not the original glass. I had to replace the glass. I had to have it professionally serviced. Some of the caps have been replaced. It's all been tested. If you look down in there, you can see there's tags on all the tubes where the tubes were all tested, and the ones that were bad were replaced, and all the capacitors that were bad were replaced. Everything tested good. Everybody wants to do a complete recap. I'm not a complete recap kind of person. To me, if it tests good, it's good. Don't fix it if it ain't broke. So we've got a little Guardians of the Galaxy here. Now, when you get this thing going here, what you got to do is you got to put this up and pull it aside, because it'll think that there's records on there, and it'll just go ahead and work in automatic mode. And watch this, how smooth this. It's actually very smooth. Comes right on. You got to remember, this thing was made in the 60s, and it's still performing like a champ with the Shure M3D cartridge. So let me do the needle. Watch this. All you do is just that right there, and off we go. And I hope we don't get a copyright here. There it goes down. The track's about 3 grams, which is, a lot of you think that's heavy, but it's really not too bad. A heavy tracking cartridge is actually kind of good. It's got a little click on that record right there, but it goes away. There's gone. Very warm, beautiful warm sound. My God, it's just a silly phase I'm going through. The thing I really love about this Kenwood, it has this heavy sound, warm, warm, heavy sound. But man, it's just, you get all the detail and all the beautiful sounds. I just love it. Beautiful is that, and you really can't hear what's going on to this stupid phone and the way the technology records this stuff. You need an external microphone to really do it right. But my goodness, sounds so beautiful in the garage with the old Girard. I just wanted to share that with you. The old Girard turntable. These are fun. If you ever see one of these in good shape, you ought to just grab it. I mean, they're cheap. You can get them cheap, and they are a lot of fun. Especially if you got some tube gear. Hook them up with an old tube amp, man. And, now, really, those speakers, those are nice speakers, but I would prefer an old set of paper speakers from back in the day. Maybe even with some horns on them to even get the optimal warmth and sound out of everything. Thank you. You know, and you really can't capture the transparency. You know, you're just going to get what you get with this phone, okay? But, I mean, the transparency is kind of magical with the weight of the tubes and the beautiful M-Sure 3D cartridge. And, hey, thanks for hanging out. I hope you enjoyed looking at this old stuff out here in the old garage. You guys have a good weekend. Take it easy.